take a bullet for you just to prove my love.
Hey you guys, today we're going to be making a GFX. So you're going to go to base plate on Roblox Studio because you're going to need Roblox Studio. You're also going to, once you're on there, you're going to press on models and then go down to plugins and install load character light. Then go to plugins and go to load character and type in your username. Mine is sushibear110 and spawn R15. Then you're going to press on base plate on the side and press backspace. And you're going to go to animation editor and you're just going to edit like it how you want your character to look. Like maybe you can make it waving or holding something. If you want it to hold something, you're going to go over to the side and press the plugins, and then you can look up model, and then you can press on models, and you can look up flowers or food, and then you can just tap on it and make it look like it's holding it or something. But I'm not going to do that. I want mine to be like dancing kind of looking. So it's dancing so that like it's like has the hand behind his head and kind of looks like it's dancing, I guess. So yeah, it's dancing. Okay. So this is what I meant before when I said like go to plugin and go to models and look up like flowers or something. So you could just like look up flowers and there's like a basket of flowers or a red flower, and maybe you could look up food, you know, whatever. And then you're going to go to file, go to advanced and press export as OBJ, and then name it whatever you want to name it. Like I'm just going to name mine my GFXYT and save that. Next thing you're going to do is go to 3D viewer. You should have this on your laptop. If it's a Windows computer, like if it's Windows based, or I don't know, but if there's a Windows on it, then you probably had this built into it. And I'm just going to go to open recent, and there's going to be like a B on there. And I'm going to press my GFXYT because that's what I saved it as. And there it is. And you have it in 3D. And if you want to take off the grid, you can go to the little grid setting right there and like press and then like scroll down and press turn, and then you can just press turn off grid, but I don't really think I need it. Yeah, so here is that, and you can like make it different light settings, all these, but I think I'm gonna keep mine white, but I'm just showing you guys the examples of what they can be. And yeah, so that's how you can do it, and you can zoom in. Mine's touchscreen, so I'm just going to zoom in like that. And yeah, that looks good. Maybe a little bit more in, and like that. And you can just choose which position you want it in by just like scrolling around or zooming in. And yeah, that's that. So then after that, when you have it in the position you want it to be, you can press Windows G, like the Windows symbol, and then G. And you can go to capture and go to the little camera symbol, and your screenshot will be saved. That's how it works on my computer. Maybe it won't work like that on yours, but just take a screenshot. Okay, so I'm going to switch to my tablet here and just crop this in Photos. And yeah, that's pretty much it. And then basically you can actually do this on Paint 3D on your Windows computer, and you can just do this all. I will give a tutorial on that later. Well, it's because Paint 3D isn't really working for me at the moment. Okay, so on mobile, I am on background eraser, and that's how I am going to be turning it into a sticker and making it see-through so I can put it on a background. So background eraser doesn't really work as well as what's it called does. Oh, Paint 3D does. So it's a little bit like way harder to do. So I very highly suggest using Paint 3D. It's really easy. All you have to do is go to Paint 3D on your computer and just press make a sticker and then make a sticker, and I'm losing my voice today, guys. After you press make a sticker, you can go to your GFX file and then just press, and then it'll just magically do it for you. Like, it'll take away the background for you and it'll turn it into a sticker. So yeah, but this is the harder way around if you really want to do it this way. I just have trouble with my Paint 3D, but you guys should definitely use it. But if you guys don't have a laptop, then, I mean, if you guys aren't working with Paint 3D either, then you guys can go on the Play Store and find this app. It's called Background Eraser. Okay, guys, hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. And yeah, this is the GFX I made with this sticker that we made with Roblox Studio and stuff. So basically, I just added a background, and yeah, I enjoy it, but I think using Paint 3D is definitely better. You will get a more exquisite product out of it. So I will show you guys at the end what a Paint 3D one looks like that I made. And so yeah, so speaking of that, that's one of the things you will need. One of the apps you will need to make this, you'll need 3D Viewer, Roblox Studio, and you will also need Background Eraser on Play Store. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll see you next time. Bye!